Hi, good morning. MC from The Upcoming. Can you tell us what nominations you're particularly excited about this year?
Oh my goodness. Well, we haven't seen everything yet. So because we had about 130 feature films submitted this year. So we wait for our very diligent voters to narrow them down to the list of nominations, and then we start watching. So there's a few that I've seen, but I've seen some of the documentaries, but haven't seen the rest of them. But it is such a range of stuff in there. That's the really lovely thing to see, you know, from Bait, which is pretty unusual micro budget feature, to, you know, a big Armando Iannucci film. I love his stuff, so I'm really excited to see that. It's a real testament to the health of the British film industry and to the incredible range of talent that we have here.
And so, as you said, there's a vast slate that you have of the nominations. What do you think is a sort of key or core thing that runs throughout all of your nominations that you have, or something that's the BIFA stamp?
All of them. I mean, these are, you know, the reason why we're supporting independent film is because it's not just to do with it's harder to make a film if it's independent. It's because the kinds of stories that you can tell if you're telling them as an independent filmmaker are very different, and the way that you can tell that story is very different. So I think looking at that reel today, it's sort of, they're all, and this is a slightly facetious thing to say, they're all very kind of deeply human stories, and what they're all doing is there's a kind of urgency about the stories that they want to tell, even if that happens to be, you know, a Charles Dickens novel. There's a lot in that that talks about life today, just as much as Forsama is telling us about life today. So I think it's the kind of the urgency of the storytelling probably is the thing that links them all together. Though there's probably not very much else that links them all together, because they're a really diverse bunch.
And obviously, the nominations show this, but what do you think is making it such an exciting time to be working in British independent cinema?
Oh, any specific thing? Gosh.
I suppose the freedom, like the diversity and range of stories, shows that there are people willing to make and fund all sorts of stories in all sorts of ways, in all sorts of locations. And I think that's exciting. It feels like the freedom to kind of get your voice out there. And I think having so many debuts as well, you know, in that list is testament that a new voice can be heard. And it's not just kind of relying on the tried and tested filmmakers or talent. There is definitely that kind of support for new voices telling new stories in new and interesting ways, which I find really, really exciting.
Yeah, and that kind of appetite of audiences to watch as well is really strong, we think. We did this piece of research to do with younger audiences' attitudes to independent film, and what it showed was that, yes, it might be that you know, a younger demographic is maybe spending a little bit more time on Netflix, but also that audience is going to the cinema a lot as well. It's not that you're doing one to the exclusion of the other, it's just there's more ways to see amazing stuff. So you get to watch, you know, you get to watch more because you can do it on the bus as well as just in the cinema.
What are you most excited about the awards this year?
Oh man, I am. See, this normally my honest answer at this point is for them to be over, because for us these next 4 weeks are quite full on. We're a very small team, and the whole thing is run kind of with a patchwork of partners and favours. But that's not the real answer. The real answer is the night itself. It's so lovely to see what these nominations mean to the nominees as they arrive. So that moment when they're all kind of on the red carpet and they arrive and it's their big night, it's just a really lovely thing to see. And then also, I get to be, you're up on the balcony, and I get to be at the side of the stage when the winners come off stage, and that is, because there's this sort of public moment on stage, and then the moment off stage where it kind of can sink in and they can go back to being themselves a bit, that's a really lovely thing to watch. So that's my favourite bit.
I think I love the bringing of the teams together, because often they'll have had a grueling schedule and horrific filming conditions, and then it's the first time sometimes they'll all have come back together as a team to celebrate, and you kind of hear like whoops from tables across the room, and also the cheering each other on. So like other films will be cheering each other, and that kind of sense of kind of community and supporting each other and celebration is really lovely. And it's also just before Christmas, so everyone's kind of gearing up to the party season as well. So that, just seeing the industry truly come together, support each other and celebrate the achievements of the year, I love that bit.
And what would you say is your key goal for the BIFA Awards, or the BIFA as the organisation?
It's kind of, I'd say it's twofold. I think we want to get more people watching these incredible films. And that's why we did the research project, and that's why we're developing a kind of always-on marketing campaign for these films throughout the year, so not just around November and December when we're championing them, but when they are being released. So working in partnership with distribution and exhibition to ensure that audiences are hearing about these films once they're battling against those films with massive budgets. And then from the other side of things, it's for supporting the community and the filmmakers. So we are diligent voters that will select and pick out anywhere between kind of 40 to 60 new debut filmmakers each year, and they've done that because they're making really good films and really believe that these filmmakers are something special. And there's a huge percentage that never go on to make a subsequent feature, and there are fundamental reasons why that is. And so we are building a program of support for them throughout the year with various incentives and various kind of skills and all sorts of things, so that we can help support them to reach their potential and make more brilliant films so that we can then sit back and enjoy them.